Good morning, students. First of all, sorry for the previous video. It was not visible clearly. That's why I made another video for you. So in this video, we are going to discuss the same chapter, that is your chapter number 1, Evolution of Computer. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about generation of computer, characteristics of computer, advantage of computer and disadvantage of computer. So let's start with generation of computer. So the history of computers referred to as different generation of computers. With every generation of computers, there was a major development in technology. As we know that technology is rapidly changing day by day. So according to the change in technology, we classified the computer or the generation of computer into 5 types. What are they? They are first generation, second generation, third generation and fourth generation, fifth generation. So first we will discuss about first generation computer. So the first generation computers were used between 1940 to 1956. Yes, in between 1940 to 1956, whatever the computers were using, that computers are classified into first generation computer. So second point is, scientists use vacuum tube as processor in them. As we know that computer needs a processor to process the work or to do the work. So here scientists use the vacuum tubes as the processor. So next point is, they were so big that they occupied an entire room. Yes, that time first generation computers are like room size. Their speed was quite low and power or electricity consumption is very high. Input in such computers were in the form of punched card and paper tapes. Yes, the punch cards and paper tapes are used as the input device in first generation computer. Their programming capacity was very low. They could not store much data. They were huge in size and very expensive. Yes, due to the vacuum tube as the processor, or we are using vacuum tube as the processor, that's why the size is big and it's very expensive. See the examples. What are the examples? IDBAC, MARC, ENIAC and EDSAC. These are the examples of first generation computer. So let's move to second generation. So the second generation computer were in use between 1956 to 1963. In between 1956 to 1963, whatever the computers were using, that are categorized into second generation computer. Transistors were used as processor instead of vacuum tubes. In first generation, we are using vacuum tubes as processor, but in second generation, transistors were used as processor. The computers were small in size and punched card are used as input device and printout as output device. So in second generation, punched card are used as input device and printout as an output device. They were more energy efficient and reliable than the first generation computers. Their operating speed was comparatively higher than the first generation computers. Yes, we know that operating speed means for doing some work or the speed of doing some work. Yes, it is comparatively higher than the first generation computer. High level programming languages like COBOL and BASIC were developed in the generation. In this generation, so what are the computers? IBM 704, IBM 1401. These are the examples, or these are the computers categorized in second generation computer. So now we will discuss about third generation computer. The third generation computer were used in between 1964 to 1971. So in 1964 to 1971, or in between 1964 to 1971, whatever the computers were using, that are categorized in third generation computer. Integrated circuits, which are tiny square chips with thousands of transistors placed. Yes, in the third generation of computer, we are using integrated circuit as processor. Keyboard were used as input device. Monitors were used as output device. They were smaller and cheaper than their earlier counterparts. Yes, it's very cheap and smaller than the first and second generation computer. They used an operating system that allowed running of many different programs simultaneously. Yes, operating system in this generation, we are using the operating system to perform many tasks at a time. So next is your fourth generation computer. The fourth generation computers were used in between 1971 to present. That means from the 1971 till now, whatever the systems or computers we are using, that are categorized in fourth generation language. Microprocessor, which is a small silicon chip, is used instead of integrated circuit. So in fourth generation computer, we are using microprocessor as processor. Keyboard, mouse used as input device, and monitor used as output device. Computer became more advanced in terms of processing and memory capacities. Yes, when we are using the microprocessor, or the processing power is more, that time we are having the more capacity to store more data, and the processing power is very high. It led to the development of personal computers. In fourth generation, we developed the personal computers or microcomputers. In 1981, IBM introduced its first computer for home user, and in 1984, Apple introduced Macintosh, the first computer of Apple company. So next we will discuss about the fifth generation computer. Fifth generation computing devices are based on artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is the ability of computers to think and act like human. So as we know that nowadays robots are having the ability to think and act like human. They are still in development stage due to addition of new technologies. As we know that technologies are rapidly changing. So for this generation also, the techniques and the technology both are changing. That's why it's still in development stage. Systems that attempt to reproduce the types of physical connection that occur in animal brains to stimulate intelligence. Programming computers to see and react the other sensory stimuli. So we now, using the programmings, the robots can hear, can see, and can react the things. So this is the example is your robot. So next we will discuss about the characteristics of computer. So first characteristic is your speed. A computer work with much higher speed and accuracy compared to human beings. Yes, the computer works very faster, or the speed of the work of computer is very high. Next is your accuracy. Since computer is programmed, so whatever input we give it gives result with accurately. Yes, what as we know that computer needs instructions to do a work. If we are going to give the wrong instruction, then it will provide the wrong output. Next, storage. Computer can store huge amount of data with appropriate format. Yes, computer can store large amount of data with appropriate format, but it is impossible in case of human beings. A human beings cannot store large amount of data with the appropriate format. Next is your diligence. Computer can work for hours without any break and creating errors. Yes, computer can work 24/7. So if a human being or a person works more than 8 to 10 hours, they get tired and they started making errors. So next is your versatility. We can use computer to perform completely different types of work at the same time. Yes, we know that we can play and listen song at the same times using the computer. Next is your power of remembering. Yes, computer can remember huge amount of data for the human beings. There is no IQ. Yes, as we know that computer needs instructions to do the work. So for every work, we have to give instructions to computer. That's why computer doesn't have any IQ. Next is your no feelings. Computer doesn't have emotion, knowledge, experience and feelings. Yes, computer doesn't have any emotion, feelings and knowledge. But nowadays we are using artificial intelligence, and by using artificial intelligence, we can add emotion and feelings in the robot also. Next, we will discuss about the advantage of computer. So first advantage is save time and perform calculation quickly and accurately. Yes, nowadays computer saves our lots of time and perform the calculations quickly and accurately. Next, avoid mistakes. Yes, by using computer we can avoid the mistakes. Get high quality and error-free work. Yes, by using the computer, we can get high quality and error-free work. Get result printed out neatly. Storage large amount of data. Next is your disadvantage of computer. Computer cannot think. Yes, for doing or for performing any task, we have to give instructions to the computer. That's why computer cannot think. Computer cannot decide on their own. As we know that also that computer need instructions to perform any task. That's why computer cannot decide on their own. Computers are dependent on electricity for their work. Yes, without electricity, we are not able to connect with the computer. Next, computer have no learning power. Yes, as we know that computer doesn't have any feelings, any emotions, nothing. So for everything, we have to give the instructions and information to the computer so that they can do the work. These are the disadvantages of the computers. Thank you, students.